Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. On behalf of Markaz Sahaba, the voice of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we present to you lesson number 1620 of our daily Naseehah and advice. Today we focus on the 25th of Ramadan. It was on the 25th of Ramadan, the year 463 after Hijrah, corresponding to the 1st of July, 1071. Alab Arsalan, the leader of the Muslim army and the king of the Seljuks, won a decisive battle against the Byzantine Empire, referring to the Christians, in a place known as Milazakart. And the emperor of the Byzantine dynasty was taken captive by the Muslims. What a humiliation, disgrace for the enemy. And even today this can happen if we are true Muslims and people with Iman. Wa antumul a'launa in kuntum mu'mineen. Almighty Allah will make you prevail and grant you superiority if you have true Iman and faith and conviction as enshrined in the noble Quran. Similarly, on the 25th of Ramadan, the year 544 after Hijrah, corresponding to the 1st of February 1150, Imam Fakhruddin Razi rahimahullah was born. His full name was Muhammad bin Umar bin Hussein bin Ali. He compiled more than 100 books, and his magnum opus and greatest contribution is the Tafsir on the Noble Quran, Tafsir-e-Kabir, Tafsir-e-Razi is known as. And remember, he was a master and a versatile scholar in all fields. So therefore, when we study these people, then we start learning the urge how to acquire and imbibe this knowledge of Quran Sharif, Sunnah Mubarakah, and the fiqh and jurisprudence. The sunnah for today, we know that tonight will be the 25th night here in South Africa and some other countries. Mustafa Rahmatulil Alameen sallallahu alaihi wasallam hadith mentioned in Mishkat Sharif and in Musnad Ahmad, various compilations. Man qama laylatul qadri imanan wa ihtisaba ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi, that whosoever stands, meaning engages and grosses himself in ibadat, you standing, sitting, the night of majesty, the night of destiny, imanan, internally the person has faith, iman, conviction, wahtisaba, and mudrikan li thawab, the person is expecting and hoping for optimum maximum reward and displaying, making manifest his love for Almighty Allah. So this 25th night we should try and exert ourselves. Ghufira lahu ma taqaddama min dhanbi, then his previous sins are forgiven, authentic hadith. So go the extra mile, revive the sunnah of Habibuna Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The dua for today, what a powerful dua. We know we are living in a toxic society, and this hadith is mentioned by Imam Bayhaqi rahimahullah. Allahumma tahhir qalbi minan nifaq. O Allah, purify my heart from hypocrisy. Allahumma tahhir qalbi minan nifaq. My heart, you purify it from hypocrisy. Wa amali min ar-riya, and my actions from ostentation, from showing people and impressing people. Wa amali min ar-riya, and my actions, ya Allah, you purify it from showing off and trying to impress people. Wa lisani min al-kidhb, kidhb you can say also. Wa lisani min al-kidhb, ya Allah, purify my tongue from lies. People today speak so many lies that it has become their second nature, Allah forbid. Allahumma tahhir qalbi min an-nifaq wa amali min ar-riya wa lisani min al-kidhb wa ayni min al-khiyana. Ya Allah, purify my eyes from the breach of trust, from seeing that which is haram, فَإِنَّكَ تَعْلَمُ خَائِنَةَ الْأَعْيُنِ وَمَا تُخْفِي الصُّدُورِ. Surely you know the treacherous and disloyal eyes and what our hearts are concealing. So all that what our ulterior motives are. One more time the entire dua. Allahumma tuhhir qalbi min al-nifaq wa amali min al-riya' wa lisani min al-kidh وعيني من الخيانة فإنك تعلم خائنة الأعين وما تخفي الصدور. May Almighty Allah Jalla wa Alaa accept our siyam, our qiyam, our itikaf, all our good deeds. Barakallahu feek. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.